There's a story that my daddy tells religiously, like clockwork every time he sees an opening in a conversation about the way things used to be. Well, I'd just roll my eyes and make a beeline for the door, but I'd always end up starry-eyed, cross-legged on the floor, hanging on to every word. Man, the things I heard. It was harder times and longer days, 5 miles of school uphill both ways. We were cane switch raised, dirt floor poor. Of course, that was back before the war. Yeah, your uncle and I made quite a pair, flying F-15s through hostile air. He went down, but they missed me by hair. He'd always stop right there and say,
"That's something to be proud of. That's a life you can hang your hat on. That's a chin held high as a tear falls down. Guts sucked in, chest stuck out like a small town flag a-flying, or a newborn baby crying in the arms of the woman that you love. That's something to be proud of."
Son, graduating college, that was mama's dream. But I was on my way to anywhere else when I turned 18. 'Cause when you got a fast car, you think you got everything. I learned quick those GTOs don't run on faith. I ended up broken down in some town north of L.A., working maximum hours for minimum wage. Well, I fell in love, next thing I know, the babies came and the car got sold. Sure do miss that old hot rod, sure save gas in them foreign jobs. Dad, I wonder if I ever let you down, if you're ashamed how I turned out. Well, he lowered his voice, then he raised his brow, said, "Let me tell you right now,
that's something to be proud of. That's a life you can hang your hat on. You don't need to make a million, just be thankful to be working. If you're doing what you're able and putting food